We'd love for you to put them on, which means you'll have to take off your sweatshirt. Put the t-shirts on because we have Mr. Parks here, Mr. Bill Parks. I just want you to know I'm going to pull down my mask while I talk because I'm immune. I've been vaxxed. I've had COVID, and I've also been boosted. We're going to ask you, if you don't mind, to take your sweater, a booklet. Thank you.
President and founder of the Best Friends Foundation, Mrs. Elaine Bennett. Give her a nice round of applause, everybody.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Ms. Laurie Williams. Just so you know, Ms. Williams arrived in town yesterday from Atlanta, and she is one of the foremost jazz performers in the world. I absolutely believe this, know this. She has performed all over the world, and she has some of the best CDs I have ever heard. So we are thrilled. She was our music director. How many years? 10 years? And so you know, she is a graduate of St. Thomas More School. Started her musical career here. Graduated from college, went to Hampton, right? And now she is teaching voice and performing. So you have a great role model right here in Ms. Williams. Thank you for coming down. And I want to let you know who a few other people are, because I know we want to stay on time. We're supposed to stop right at 1, but maybe we could have maybe an extra 5 to 10 minutes because we have great raffle prizes for you. Unless you want to forget the the Visa cards. Do you want to forget those? Sure, you don't. You could just maybe, we won't do the $50 Visa, maybe. And maybe we just won't do the $100 one. But you want to do it. Okay, so maybe we'll go a little bit over time. We have some terrific performers who are from Washington, D.C. They have performed all over. I would like to introduce one of them who has been with us for 20 years. If Miss Burns, Miss Rita Burns, would please stand up. She was one of the primary performers in the Marvin Gaye musical. What's going on? How many performances? Ten cities for 3 years? For 3 years. Can you imagine the physical work that takes? Some of you may be watching the Olympics, but I'm telling you, dancing and that many shows is truly a feat. So we are so honored that Ms. Burns is here, and she has worked out hand motions to a lot of our songs, and we certainly hope that you feel moved to join in. We'd love to see that. I'd also like to introduce Ms. Robin Williams, who is our program director. We are delighted that Ms. Williams joined Best Friends again February the 1st, and after she worked with us for 10 years, and then another organization came and stole her away, but she came back to us, and we are thrilled. And she left under very good terms. We knew she was going. She had a great opportunity, but we needed her more because she's got the best friend spirit about as well as anybody we know. Right, Mrs. Hamlet? And Mrs. Hamlet, I've got to stand up because Mrs. Hamlet is the person you want to impress today. If you don't impress anybody else, she is the one because she's going to decide who gets some awards and some prizes. So, Mrs. Hamlet was the principal at Amadon Elementary, and she invited Best Friends Foundation in 1987. And here we are going on how many years? Who's good at math? How many years? How many years? Loud? 35. 35 years. And we wouldn't have. We would not have visited 15 cities, 10,000 students, given probably, I think the last count, $5 million in scholarship money. And we want to give away more. And we want to give this to the eighth graders who follow along with us and hang with us till 12th grade, because we just gave a big award last June at our graduation with grace ceremony. So without further conversation, because I know we're on a time schedule here, I'm going to turn it back over to Ms. Williams and our incredible performers, singers, dancers, and they're going to teach you something if you want to learn.
We're going to teach you about this rap called Respect. Say the word respect. Okay. All right. We're gonna put the beat. Here we go, Mr. Chris, we got it. It goes like this. It's called Respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. I give it to you, and you give it to me. It's called Respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. You gotta treat people respectfully. It's called Respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. I give it to you, and you give it to me. It's called Respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. You gotta treat, can I hear you? Come on, it's called Respect. It's called respect. You got it.
Little louder, let me hear you.
It's called respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
I give it to you, and you give it to me.
Y'all get up on your feet. Come on, stand on up, stand on up. Let me see you. Come on, do it again. It's called respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
I give it to you, and you give it to me. It's called respect.
R-E-S-P-E-C-T. We gotta treat people respectfully. It's called respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Lights down, lights down. Come on, it's called respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. You gotta treat people respectfully. Let's go.
Hey, DSM, make some noise one time for the one time. I see ya. I see ya. Let's go. Hey.
They do.
So use a lyric, chippy like a stick of the brick.
You get my gist?
Uh-huh.
Now you see how I feel. See, the feelings ain't a game. I got a name and I'm real. So all you bullies, back off and get back. Listen to yourself before you start an attack. Yeah. Some people have a reason to do what they do. Maybe they saw it before. Maybe it happened to you.
True.
Or maybe it's something in your life you've seen. Maybe on the TV or the computer screen. But it doesn't make it right when you know that it's wrong. You know the truth is inside.
You gotta treat people respectfully. It's called respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. I give it to you, and you give it to me. It's called respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. You gotta treat people respectfully.
Children, yes, who will feel?
Future the front.
Can they do it?
Have a fine. Hey! Work, baby, work.
Gotta get the job done.
Come on.
Then it's time for a whole lot of fun.
On the run, ain't lunch, then yes, recess. Yourself. That's way the feelings I heard.
So focus on the mission at hand.
Uh-huh.
Plan. Yeah. The foster your success.
Yeah.
Demand on
yeah.
The best.
You can do it.
Yeah.
You
can
teach
yeah.
More. And you can shine in the world.
Yeah.
You can get your reward.
Good grades open doors down the road. Don't you know? Good grades, good job, good show.
R-E-S-P-E-C-T. You gotta treat people respectfully. It's called respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. I give it to you, and you give it to me. It's called respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
Come on, TSM,
you gotta
sing it with me now.
Respect.
What is it called? It's called
respect.
Thank you, eighth graders. I think we got some really talented students here today. I'm seeing them. because we have a lot to share with you and we don't have a lot of time. And what we'd like to do are the ask the 4 7th graders, I believe it is, Miss Williams, and the 4 8th graders who were selected to read. Do we know who you are? Come forward, please. Please come up. Thank you. What we'd like you to do, please, is that Jaden? Jaden, would you please stand right here? And Mr. Carlos is going to hold something up for you to read.
Jaden in seventh grade. My name is Jaden Lyles, and I'm in seventh grade. If your friends are mean, get new friends.
Thank you, Jaden. I believe in that one. Okay, Stefan. Would you please read what Mr. Carlos is
doing? My name is Stefan Lockridge. I'm in the seventh grade. It is not cool to be mean.
Some people think it is cool to be mean. Have you met those people? Yes. I have. Okay, we would like to hear from Edwin.
My name is Edwin Bonilla Benitez. I'm in seventh grade. The best friend to have is one who makes you a better person. The best friend to have is the one who makes you a better person.
Thank you. Would you please put that on the tripod? Thank you. And Giovanni?
And Giovanni Gwynn. Giovanni Gwynn? My name is Giovanni Gwynn. Oh, I'm in seventh grade. And no one deserves to be picked on or bullied. No one deserves to be picked or bullied.
Thank you, Giovanni. And would you please go there? Thank you. And it looks like we have Jamie.
Could you please say your name and turn around to the audience?
My name is
Jamie, and I'm in the eighth grade. Jamie Baker. I'm in the eighth grade. You should not be afraid of your friends.
My name is Tanji White, and I'm in the eighth grade. Remember, what you send in a text will last forever.
Tanji, that is one thing. If you don't take away anything else today, understand what you're doing when you send a text. It goes to the cloud. You cannot get it back, even if they tell you you can. And let me tell you, colleges are checking, and so are employers. So be very careful, very careful. Thank you. Samir?
My name is Samir Davis, and I'm in eighth grade. National Domestic Violence Hotline, 1-800-799-SAFE.
Samir, what do you think that's for?
I don't know, for the police.
When would you call that number? When would you call that number, Samir?
When I'm in trouble, most likely.
That again more clearly.
Most likely when I'm in trouble.
When you are in trouble, when someone is hurting you, or someone is hurting someone you care about, this is a number that that we want you to remember. Now, how are you going to remember it?
Put in some notes.
All right, what if you don't have pencil or paper? What about the brain? You know it's 1-800. Got that part, right? You know the last part is safe. You don't have to remember 7233. You just remember the word safe. Now, three things you got to remember. 799. Who can say it right now?
799.
Safe, right? I think I saw this gentleman. Excuse me, Caden.
Would you like to stand up and say the whole number without looking at it?
1-800-799.
Safe.
Right. Way to go. Who is this? Orlando. Orlando. Thank you, Orlando. Anybody over here can do it? Turning around, not looking at it?
We have one more who's standing
Sir.
Right up front.
Come on,
Cody.
1-800-799-SAFE. Thank you, Cody.
And we have one student who's here? Standing right here for you, Mrs. Bennett.
Oh, this gentleman right here.
1-800-799-SAFE.
And he's going to read the last. He's going to read the last sign for us.
Yeah, this is a hard one. You want to read it?
Yes.
I bet you can. Okay. You got to read it slow, because there's a word you have to emphasize. The first word you have to emphasize is do, and the last word you have to emphasize is not. Can you do it?
It is not only for what we do that we are held responsible, but also for what we do not do.
Thank you, Caden. I think he may have a future on stage. He got those words. A lot of students don't get that, because it's not just what you do that people see, but when you don't do something you should do, like help someone in trouble, like speak up when you know somebody's getting hurt, like doing that, like just saying, well, no, I'm not going to be bothered with that right now. I've got to get on with my life. I've got to do other things. It's for what you do not do, you're also responsible for. I would like, if Ms. Williams would come forward, please. We're going to talk to you about something we think is really important. And thank you, students.
Let's give them a nice round of applause.
Did a
for
great
that.
Job.
Thank you.
Thinking we should jump to the creed, and then we'll come back
that
with
sounds,
the friendship questions.
That sounds fantastic.
Okay. Mr. D'Angelo Anderson, who is our outreach coordinator for Best Friends.
Hello, everyone. As she said, I am D'Angelo Anderson, the outreach manager of Best Friends Foundation. So, today we wanted to talk to you about our core values, the things that literally represent us in everything we do. So first, we have the eagle for foresight, for the future. The lion, strength and courage. Anchor, stability. And the gavel for truth and justice.
The heart, friendship and consideration. The book, knowledge. The torch, leadership, and showing the way. So this is what we would like to do now. We read it, but we would like for all of you to participate. Is that okay? So we're going to say the first word, and you read its meaning. Is that okay? All right, D'Angelo?
Eagle.
I think you guys could do much better than that. You ready? Here we go.
Eagle.
Foresight for the future.
Lion.
Strength and courage.
Anchor.
Stability.
Gavel.
Truth and justice.
Heart.
Friendship and consideration.
Book.
Knowledge.
Torch.
Leadership and showing the way.
So I'm going to leave that up there for about 10 seconds. I want you guys to take a really good look at that. Five, four, three, two, one. It's gone. I need someone to come up and tell me what these words and terms mean. So I'm going to give a random, let's say, I need someone to tell me what heart, what does heart mean? Come on up. Or Mrs. Bennett. Okay.
Say your name, sir. Savion, eighth grade. Friendship and consideration.
Woo, stand there, stand there. Oh, wait a minute, you're not finished. Mrs. Bennett, if you can stand, please, remain standing. Let's see how much he's been listening. How about the torch? Oh, okay, so stand. Okay, remain standing. Oh, yes. Anyone for the torch?
My name is Tangie, and the torch is leadership and showing the way.
Come on, give her a hand. Excellent, 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 excellent job. Can someone tell me tell me what the ego is about?
You got one over here.
A best man.
My name is Jaden, and the eagle stands for foresight.
Foresight for the... Excellent. Remain standing. Come on, stand up, stand up, stand up. Stand up. Yes. D'Angelo, what's the next one?
The next one. The anchor.
Tie between these two. Miss Hamlet, this gentleman, I saw both the hands.
Stability.
Stability, give him a hand. Did we miss one? The lion, I think we missed the lion. And the, okay, well hold that one. The lion, yes.
Let's
come on,
lion.
That's the one on this side, the
lion. Raise your hand, lion. Come on, you can take that. This gentleman right here. Okay, what does the lion stand for?
Strength and courage.
Strength and courage.
Awesome, awesome, awesome.
Good
awesome.
For him. Good for him. And you opened your book, right? Which is allowable. You can do that. You can do that. We want you to remember, but... But actually, I think you
remember.
Okay, what's your name?
Samir Davis.
Samir. Okay, there was one other one.
We have one for the gavel.
The gavel.
My name is Seven William, and the gavel means justice and equality.
Truth and justice. Exactly.
Okay. Did we cover every creed? Which one are we missing? The book. Oh, someone right up front. Right up front.
The book.
Yes, we have.
Knowledge.
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 Okay. For everyone who participated, for everybody who participated, I need you to stand.
Is knowledge important? Nah, we don't care, right? We don't need to learn anything, do we?
There is no secret to success. It is hard work. Okay, can we give all of these participants a big round of applause? So out of all of the students who are standing, I need one of you to list all of the queens. You cannot. Just think about it, 5 seconds. The first pen that I see, I'm going to bring you up. As many as you can. Think about it. Count on your hands.
It's not in the book. It's not. How many of you can at least give me three?
Who wants to try?
At least three.
Tanji?
In the back? His hand first. His hand was first. Let's give him a hand. Okay. Give me at least three grades.
The eagle is foresight, the anchor is stability, and the line is courage.
Okay. Courage.
Can you say that loud and clear so we all can hear?
The book is knowledge, the anchor is stability, and the line is courage.
Got it.
What did he say?
The book?
Excellent.
Right.
You're leaving me so fast. Come on, everyone, let's give him a big round of applause. I need you here. I need you with me. Thank you, guys. You guys can have a seat.
We have a young man in the back who I believe knows all of them.
Someone knows all of them? If you know all of them, please stand. Please come forward.
Whoever gets up there first, do it. I think we got a gentleman right here, Ms. Williams.
Okay, here we go. I need everyone's undivided attention.
You need to be able to hear
it. I need you to stay up here. Stand up here. Let us see your name. Let us see your name. Okay, here we go.
The eagle is foresight. The lion is strength and courage. Book is knowledge. Gavel is truth and justice. The heart is friendship. The torch is leadership. And the anchor is stability.
All right.
Whoa.
He's got it.
That was fantastic. Please let us see your name. Please give us your name.
Jahari.
And what is your teacher's name?
Miss Taylor.
Awesome, Miss Taylor. And give us your grade.
A.
He deserves a big round of applause. So, we couldn't just stop there. We had to give them a special gift, a special prize for participating and doing a wonderful job. So,
what can it be?
Jaden, on behalf of the Best Friends Foundation, we would like to present you with a $25 Visa gift card. Good job. And for this young man, Jahari, on behalf of the Best Friends Foundation, we would like to thank you for doing a wonderful job. And we would like to present you with a $30 gift card. Give him a hand. Keep up the good work.
Congratulations, Jahari. Congratulations, Jaden.
To a song that actually talks about the positive images that are on this creed of the Best Friends Foundation, and bring up Lauren Kayla Holland and Sol Edler. And the rest of the ensemble is going to just disperse in between the crowd. And we're going to sing this song that is popular by a singer named Desiree. And it's called You Gotta Be. Here we go.
You, my, oh my, hey, hey. stronger. You gotta be
cool, you gotta be
calm,
you gotta stay together.
All I know is love will save the day. Time has no questions, it goes on without you, leaving you behind if you can't stand a place. The world keeps on spinning, can't stop it if you try.
That was great. Does anybody know who wrote that song?
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Elder. Anybody know? Anybody know? You know who wrote that song and sang that song? Ariel? Right. Oh.
Desiree.
And?
Desiree.
Desiree. Desiree, you're right. How did you know that? Good for you. Not a lot of students know that. Because that's a song that's been around a long time. So somebody played that at your house, right? Good. Your mom did? Would you give her a big hug when you go home? I think, Miss Hamlet, I think we have somebody we want to remember. Ariel, am I pronouncing it correctly? Thank you. What we want to do is point out one thing right here, because if we didn't, we wouldn't be talking about our name.
Best friend.
And who the best friends and to have, the best, who is the best friend to have? It's that person who helps make you a better person. And it's not always easy to figure out who to pick for a friend. And it's not always easy to be a good friend yourself. So I would like to ask the students, what is a friend? Ariel?
A friend is someone who always, like, a friend is someone who doesn't treat you badly.
A friend does not treat you badly. Exactly. Anybody else?
Would you say your name?
My name is Seven William, and a friend is someone who lifts you up and treats you kindly, like as everyone else, and help you achieve your goals.
Yes. Very nice. A friend is someone who treats you kindly and helps you achieve your goals, who lifts you up instead of pulls you down. Right? Somebody else? Elaine? What is a friend?
A friend is someone who respects you.
Respects you. That's what we started out with.
We have some participants.
I give it to you. You give it to me. You got to treat people.
Davion Wallace. A friend is a person who tells you when you're doing something wrong.
Wow. That's not always easy. How many of you would tell your friend if he or she were doing something wrong?
Ooh.
Raise your hand. How many of you would tell? I mean, if you won't tell, don't raise your hand. Okay? It's hard. The fifth graders, sixth graders weren't sure they'd tell their friend. Because one little boy said, well, I'm going to lose him as a friend. But he's a fifth grader. He's 10. How old are you?
13.
What is a 13, 14-year-old understand that if you have to, if you lose a friend because you say, hey, that's not right, you can't do that, then maybe that's not a friend you want to keep.
That's an associate.
That is a good point. I like that. Xavion? Xavion just said that person is an associate, not a friend. I really like that. We might have to put that in the curriculum. What? First of all, do you know what the word trait means? T-R-A-I-T? I want to get it right. Tanji?
My name is Tanji, and a trait is like a characteristic or personality.
That's a better word. Characteristic. Trait is a characteristic of a person, their trait. What traits do you look for in a friend?
Loyalty.
Loyalty. I love that. Anybody else? Someone?
Kindness.
Kindness. Hey, maybe somebody read that poster out in your upper lobby. Thank you. Kindness is what?
Is kindness cooler?
Yes.
We think it's cooler. Some people aren't so sure. So you look for loyalty. You look for kindness. Those are traits. Anyone over here? What traits do you look for in a friend? What characteristics do you look for in a friend? Ariel, I know. Oh, Tashana, I haven't heard from you.
Honesty.
Honesty. And honesty, if you have honesty in a friend, then that friend's going to tell you, hey, you're going to get in trouble if you do this. You're going to get in trouble. What else would you look for?
I look for respect.
Respect. We talked about that. Got to treat people respectfully. Xavion, you have one more trait?
Reliable.
Yes, someone you can count on who is reliable. I have another question here. How would you help your best friend make a good decision? How would you do that? I think I saw Aria.
I would help my best friend make a good decision by telling her, if she's doing anything wrong and being kind to her no matter what.
Anything wrong, I didn't hear the last part. Okay, so you're gonna be kind to her no matter what, but you would tell her if she was doing something wrong, right? Okay, there's a couple things on page 13, if you open your books, in what we call the express lane. It gives you some choices. The first one, would you be truthful about the situation? Would you tell them the truth? Like, look, you may think that guy likes you, and you may think he's cool, but I'm going to tell you something. I don't think he really likes you. Would you say that to a girlfriend? And the same guys, would you say, you may think that girl likes you, but I'm not so sure. That's a risk. Would you share your feelings, first of all? Would you share what you thought? Or would you just keep it under wraps, as we say? Just keep your head down. Don't say anything. Don't make any trouble. Don't make waves. Just keep on keeping on. Would you explain the negative consequences? Like, would you explain the negative consequences? You got a choice here on page 13. You would. Good. I'm glad to hear that. Tell me your name.
Orlando.
Remember.
Okay, then your other choice is just don't say anything. Keep your friend, make life easier, don't say anything. Okay, you have four choices. Which ones of those four are good and which are not good? Can you see? I think we gave you a little tip, didn't we?
Something about a situation. Some people might take offense, but a lot of people
don't.
So you got to be careful with what you say.
Yeah, I hear that. And can I see your name? Jaden. Jaden says, well, sometimes you got to be careful because there are people who will take offense and they might get angry and they might get violent. But we're not talking about you going up to someone on the street and saying, pick up that piece of paper you just dropped. We're not talking about taking on, if you're a 13, 14-year-old, taking on a much older person or somebody you don't know. We're talking about talking to someone you do know, a peer. What is a peer? Hang with, a peer is someone your own age. A peer is your friend. Ms. Williams,
yes,
you have some questions.
I do, the next question. Should you tell your friends when you think they are doing something wrong? I repeat, should you tell your friends when you think they are doing something wrong? Oh, I have a whole lot of, yes. I saw a young lady's hand up in the back and then I'm gonna come right over to you. Yes. All the way in the back. Let me see if I can bring and get the microphones right here. I saw your hand first. Yes? If you could please stand and please say your name.
Ariel. Oh. Yes, because.
Can you guys hear her?
No. Yeah, yes, because they could get in trouble. You don't want your friends to get in trouble.
Very good. Elaine, it's a young lady over there in the corner who had her hand raised. Yes. Please tell her your name. Tell us your name.
My name is Chanel Hamilton, and if my friend is wrong, I'm going to tell them that they're wrong because I don't want no one to say anything back to them that could hurt them, or I don't want them hurting other people's feelings.
It's a very good answer. Very good answer. Absolutely. Can we have the next question? What are some things you should not do for each other? What are some things you should not do for each other? This young man over here. Elaine, right over here. Yes, please. Oh, I'm sorry, right in the corner. Right, straight ahead. Yes. Please stand and state your name.
You shouldn't.
Please give us your name first.
My name is Seven. And you shouldn't harm anybody or like do physical or mental damage to anybody.
Shouldn't harm if your friend says, let's jump on him.
Excellent.
Let's beat him up.
That's right.
He's been mean to me. I don't like him. Let's jump on him. So what do you say?
No.
No, I'm not going to hurt somebody just because you think they need to be hurt. I'm not going to do that.
We have someone. I see a hand in the back.
They can't do it, you do it. You do it for them. Because you can't.
Can you say your name and speak a little louder?
My name is Tanaya, and I'm in the eighth grade. And because they can't do it, you shouldn't do it for them.
Exactly. Whoa. Don't do somebody else's particularly dirty work.
That's right.
If somebody's talking bad behind somebody's back, don't you join in? Would you want them to do that to you? There is such a thing called the golden rule. Does anybody know what it is? Anybody know what the golden rule is? The golden rule. This young lady does, and her name is?
Would you please tell us what it is?
Treat people how you want to be treated.
Please give us your name.
Treat others how you want to be treated.
Treat others
how you want to be treated.
Awesome. What is your name?
Layla Williams.
Beautiful. Oh, nice name, Williams.
Excellent answer.
Another way to say that is to do unto others as you would have them do unto you.
Yes. All right. Elaine, we have one final question.
Okay.
And that question is, how do friends support each other? That's very important. How do friends, yes, we have. Elaine has someone over in this area.
I'm Jaleesa Barnes. Jaleesa Barnes. How I support my friends is I go to their events and like award ceremonies, and like when they're feeling blue about or nervous about it, I help them.
Very good.
She goes to their events, and when they're feeling blue or nervous,
very special,
she helps them. We have somebody.
Yes, a young man in the back. Please say your name and give us your response. How do friends support each other?
My name is Zaquan. And how friends support each other is like when they're sad or down, you help them and like support them through everything.
Oh, wow.
Thank you, Saquon. Raise them up, right? Raise them up on eagle's wings. Anybody knows where that came from? Any more, Miss?
I think we have completed that area.
We have concluded that section.
Please give yourselves a big round of applause. You have been wonderful participants. Excellent.
You will be getting an evaluation. I think some of you've gotten it. Good. And filled it. Great. Because we want to know what you think. And has anyone not finished their evaluation? Everybody's finished? And we'd love to see some comments. But while you're finishing up, because we want to hear what you want and what you need, because we want to come back. Ariel, we have somebody we're going to give some awards out. Can you hold it just a second, or is there something you want to say right now? Okay.
I was going to ask you if you were going to ask us the number.
Oh, the number. Ariel wants to know what that number is. Who remembered what the hotline number is? Yeah. I think it is this gentleman.
one 800 799 safe.
Everybody, come on, say it. Here we go. 1-800-799-SAFE. Come on, say it. Here we go, y'all.
1-800-799-SAFE.
Do it again. Come on, here we go. Say it again.
1-800-799-SAFE.
Everybody, last time. Here we go.
1-800-799-SAFE.
Awesome.
We all remember better to music, right? Now, Mrs. Pauline Hamlet has something very, very important to share with you.
Well, the first thing I want to say to you, you have been a wonderful audience. Wonderful audience. And I have been watching you, so I'm going to walk around and I'm going to pick out several of you to come up front. And then I'm going to give some prizes. I'm excited when I see you as you are. You have been absolutely a wonderful group. Give yourselves a big round of applause.
Yes, you never know who's watching. You never know who's watching.
Thank you, Ms. Hammer. Ariel, come forward, please, ma'am. Oh, Savant. Seven. Another young man. Turn your name tags around. Samir, and we have another young lady. Turn your name tag, please. Zariah.
Congratulations.
Oh, and we have a teacher. My goodness, my goodness. This happened.
Well, the thing that's important, I've been watching you, but I was also watching the teachers because they have to be involved too. Not saying all of you weren't, but I'm particularly in this young lady here, and your name is? Miss Gibson. Miss Gibson was the biggest cheerleader we had in the room. And I do appreciate that. So I'm gonna turn the mic over here. We really don't have enough prizes for everybody, but so what we're gonna do is we're gonna do the best we can.
All right, do we want them to read out what they're awarded or would
that
you
would
just-
That would be great.
Well, okay.
I have a $50 Visa gift card. I have a $30 Vanilla gift card. I have a $50 Visa gift card.
I have a $30 gift card.
I have a $100 Visa gift card.
I have a $100 gift card.
Congratulations, Sage, and every one of you. Keep up the excellent work. You never know who's watching. You never know who's watching. Okay. Congratulations to those of you who were participating. But I have a question. Those of you who got gift cards, would anybody like to take their gift card and give it to somebody else? You don't have to. Would anybody, does anybody want to share their gift card?
Oh, wow.
With
Elaine?
Someone
Elaine.
Else.
Elaine, this gentleman right here.
Orlando. No, Orlando, you stand up.
Oh, Orlando, stand up.
You stand up, Orlando, and say who you shared it with and why.
I gave it to Giselle because he was participating a lot with me. He walked up there, you know, he had his hand raised. Yeah, that's what he
was. So what do you want to say?
Thank you, Orlando.
Is he a friend?
Yes.
I think so.
Yes.
Okay.
You don't have to. Anybody else? Anybody else want to share? Okay. Congratulations
Elaine.
To all of you. We've got a song.
Elaine.
Okay.
Elaine, please forgive me, but we would be remiss. We had two incredible dancers on stage, and they did a phenomenal job. Please give a big round of applause for Rita Burns.
Christopher McFadden Gooding.
We could not forget about them.
And Christopher Good. Yes. Excellent. Actually, we need to give a big applause to Laurie Taylor.
Lauren Kayla Holland.
If I've got her name right.
Beautiful song.
You've got to be. And Mr.
Sol
Troy
Edler.
Edler.
And of course, Chris Davis, our accompanist.
Chris Davis, everyone.
Chris Davis.
And J9 Sound. Nicole Lopez.
And
Carlos Hood.
Carlos.
Outstanding. And Louis Davis.
Absolutely.
Who is an actor who graduated from Catholic University.
In Orlando.
Didn't you?
Howard,
I'm sorry. Sorry, Mr. Davis. I thought I had it right. All right, and we had... Is there anybody we did not thank? I think we got
it. Tiara Robinson. Anna.
Anna Barrio Nuevo.
Marcus Dade over here.
Mrs. Barrio Nuevo, who's our hospitality coordinator.
Yes.
And we have, special, you want to tell them what we have?
We have a special treat for all of you, so when you're ready to leave, I will hand you one, okay? Elaine, D'Angelo,
and Lauren Monty. Lauren Monty has broken her ankle.
Outstanding, thank you.
She put the entire PowerPoint together. She fell, broke her ankle in three places. She is really hurting, and she came today because she wanted to be with you.
She is
our communications manager at the Best Friends Foundation.
Phenomenal.
And D'Angelo Anderson, I think I told you, is what at the Best Friends Foundation? Who remembers? He is a manager, outreach manager. So when
Good
you
job.
Need questions answered, give them your email.
And we want to thank Mrs. Pauline Hamlet.
Mrs. Hamlet.
And our special guest. We're ready to end our show with a wonderful song called Make Music, Not Madness. Stand on up, y'all.
Make music,
hey,
not madness. Make music, music.
Today.
Sisters and brothers, we gotta make some goodness, do away with the badness, and just, let's go, y'all. Make music.
foundation. Two, three.
Thank you, Mr. Davis. That was terrific. No, it's time for you to get back to your classrooms. But one of the things we want you to do is to please thank your teachers, because you wouldn't be here today if your teachers hadn't agreed for you to come out of their classroom, take time away from your academics to come and be with us for an hour, because they have a lot they have to accomplish. They're under scrutiny, and they know that Ms. Schuler is watching. We have to thank the teachers, but we also have to go up to Ms. Schuler, and maybe, yes, maybe Ms. Williams would ask Mr. Christopher to bring over the roses for Ms. Schuler, the assistant principal, who has been with us every step of the way, who made sure that you were able to get here from your classes, who worked with the cafeteria, who helped us tremendously. Thank you,
Ms. Schuler. On behalf of the Best Friends Foundation, we cannot thank you enough. Ms. Schuler has been amazing. You have been patient. You have been extremely kind, accommodating. I can go on and on, but again, on behalf of Mrs. Bennett and the entire staff, we cannot thank you enough. This is, we thank you and we appreciate you. Thank you. And let's stand to our feet. Everyone stand to your feet. And let's give Ms. Schuler a big round of applause and tell her thank you. This is presented from the foundation.
We only have four of these t-shirts left. You can keep it or give it away, whichever you choose.
We love you, Ms. Schuler.
Thank you.
A lovely, lovely day.
We'd like for you to please pick up around your table and put your workbook back in your backpack. We hope that you will open that workbook when you get home. There's a lot of information in there we did not get to cover. What we want to do is give you a graduation gift, eighth graders. When you graduate from St. Thomas More, our goal is to make sure that every one of you have one of these books. This is a result. Today, they didn't have to, from the Diana Davis Spencer Foundation, Ms. Nicole Shaw, and Ms. Elizabeth Grimaldo.
Let's give our very special guests a big round of applause and tell them thank you.
Thank you to the Best Friends for putting this on. It's absolutely amazing. I wish each of you students good luck, and you guys are doing great. I had so much fun, and the rap song, Respect. I'm going to be jamming on that going home.
Each and every one of you, you're all great kids, and I just love this. So thanks for having us.
And they didn't have to come. They decided, and they got here. They even were going to come a whole hour earlier. So we are indebted that they take their responsibilities seriously. We take our responsibility seriously. We want you to have a great school year the rest of the year. We hope to come back. We hope Ms. Schuler will ask us back.
because we have a lot more to tell you. Have a great, great evening. Hug your teachers and hug your parents. Thank you.